We are feeding the dogs. Or I should say Drew's feeding the dogs.
Come here, buddy.
Oops. We hope you guys are having a good Monday morning. Amelia and Mocha have really just made themselves at home. Amelia is, we can't wait to give her to her family because she's so ready for them. And as soon as she sees them and smells their scent and remembers that they're the fun ones on the phone. I can't wait. It's gonna be really great. Yeah. And we're like 2 weeks away, I think.
Yeah.
Just over 2 weeks.
September.
So.
No, 3 weeks.
That was like September 12th.
Oh, I thought it was.
Yeah, we're like 2 weeks.
Oh, that was September 14th.
August 28th.
Oh, that's right, it's the 28th.
Yeah. So, like, is that ours? They're about to go to their pen, so I wanted to make sure you guys saw them.
Pom-pom.
Amelia and Mocha are like, what, not us? Pom-pom goes first because Pom-pom is mom and mom is more dominant. We've got to live by the rules of the pack now.
No,
Pom-pom. Since they're kind of hanging with the pack, that's part of kind of what they're learning, what putting them with the pack of dogs kind of creates these scenarios that they learn from. It gives them the opportunity to see that, oh, okay, yeah, mom is a pack member who is more dominant than the puppies. You know, they fall beneath Vienna, for instance. The puppies are puppies, but they're not peers like children are. They still have their own hierarchy. Aw, Amelia. She's back in the bed over there. Mocha's like, where'd Amelia go? Amelia, don't be sad. We're next. We hope you're all doing well. I'm almost finished with my video for our channel members. I made a video about, it was when we mated Myra. I recorded almost the entire encounter. And so I made it into a video. It's about 8 minutes long. That just kind of talks about, mating and the whole, like, the canine courtship rituals and all the things that all moms do. Amelia just got through. All the things that dogs do, the reasons for it. But, Amelia, where'd you go? Amelia! 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 Amelia decided she wanted to see puppies. That was a risky move, but let's say hi since we're in here. There's the babies. Oh, it's kind of dark. Pom is a little worried. Sorry, about the camera. I'm trying to fix that now. All right. Amelia thought it was going to be a good idea to dare Missy with her puppies. Yeah, she about gave me a heart attack. My heart is still, like, pounding. Oh, you know, I'll just put her in. Well, I was going to put her in the pen. I figured you were, like, just waiting, but I could just put her over.
Yeah, that's fine.
We're just going straight to the pen. Hi, Pom.
Go ahead, Pom. Eat your food.
Eat your food, sweetie. Eat your food, Pom. Go eat. She's still waiting. That is why Robin is but what I was telling you guys about the video, but since I had so much footage, it ended up being really good footage. Good grief, Papa. Myra was a really good sport, and so was Spike. And they were kind of doing a lot of, they were doing a lot of the things that really illustrated some of the concepts we've tried to talk about. Robin's chasing a fly.
Pom pom, baby.
It's our breakfast.
It's my breakfast. Oh my gosh. I'm so hungry.
No.
I'm excited to release that video for you guys.
Hush up. Good girl. She wants love. Like every morning, she wants breakfast with loving.
He's not lying. He does this every morning. Robin has to get this belly rub.
Sit. Wait.
And whenever I hear it, it's. Dad still has to come over here with another rub.
Wait. Yes, go girl.
Eat your food. Eat your food.
Pom pom.
Eat your food. So this is how we make 12 dogs work. They all get fed in different like corners of the house. Remy and Myra are in the laundry room. Spike and Macchiato are in the Four Seasons room at Rio. They're in the Four Seasons room. Rio and Vienna are in the doggy bathroom. Missy is with her puppies.
Okay. Now,
Daisy is over with.
Fine.
Robin, go eat your food. Go eat. Go eat. Go eat. Go eat your food. Go eat your food.
There we go. That'll get Robin to eat. She finished your food there.
Oh, bring Pom Pom in. Oh, good idea.
Yeah.
Oh,
Missy. No.
Should
I stay in here and supervise
and
go
here
and
chasing her? No, stay right there. No, she's not going to do anything. Oh, you coming out here too?
Is that all right?
Yeah. All right, good boys. Good boy, good sit. That's a good boy. And they are not normally like they're. We don't leave them in these crates always. Oh yes, I know.
They have free reign. So Spike and Macchiato have free reign of the Four Seasons room.
Spike, Macchiato.
It's a Four Seasons room because it's all four seasons. It's
Rio.
Climate controlled.
Macchiato.
And so they.
Macchiato.
Hi.
Macchiato.
He's like, I want to go get my puppies. I know that I have puppies.
That's it. Good boy.
But
good boy. Good
they
boy.
Eat in their crates to separate them.
Yeah, so they don't eat each other.
We always have to keep in mind that our dogs are not fixed. And so they have the childhood dogs that he and I grew up with that were
good
all
boy.
Spayed or neutered.
Good boy.
They didn't have a lot of those natural instincts that end up kind of going away when...
Here comes the
B.O. When your hormones are all taken away.
Hey. Hi, Mom.
Hey,
Mom. Hi,
buddy.
Yeah, his turn is such a good boy.
You are a good boy.
He's gonna be a good man. A good dog man. What you doing, buddy?
Real. That's the door that goes to our bedroom. So if that helps kind of lay out the house a little bit better. This is the outside. That goes to the kitchen over there, past Drew.
Kitchen.
That goes to our bedroom. The barking, if you can hear the barking, that's Missy.
And over here, this
door. And
then
we have the door to the basement.
Yeah,
which is open.
Which is a little open.
Rio, eat your food.
Eat your food, Rio. Come on. Rio, eat your food. Eat your food, bud. Go eat.
Eat your food, Rio.
Silly boy.
I'll go. He's like, I want to stay with Mom.
Why? Oh, it's the phone.
I love you, Mom. I love
you,
Mom.
Boy. You want to look at yourself? Is that what it is? You want to look at how handsome you are? Oh my gosh, I've got to respond to Theo's mom. Did you see her photos of Theo?
No.
Oh my gosh, he basically looks just like Rio,
whoa,
but without the fluff.
Whoa,
he has
really?
He has the sleek.
The sleek fur?
It's real sleek.
Oh, so more like.
More like Pom.
Yeah, more like Pom-Pom.
But he has the same physique.
Really?
Very same physique. They look the very same in the face.
By the way, have you felt his testicles recently?
Not in the last few days.
They have definitely grown.
Holy smokes.
Yeah.
Yay.
Definitely.
You're becoming a man.
I am a man.
You're becoming a stud.
A stud dog.
Okay.
All right, wait. Now, wait.
Okay, back to the kitchen.
To the kitchen.
Maybe it's worse.
So they're like, they go on ultra high alert when we have puppies.
No.
So apologies for all of that. They're all on super high alert whenever we have puppies in the house, and then naturally all of our moms, they're always just, you know, extra alerty. They're really, Robin, you're such a pretty girl. Yes, you're so pretty. I can't wait to see your babies. She and Macchiato are gonna have gorgeous puppies. I can't wait to see them. Remy, that's enough. Hi, Robin, eat your food, baby. Eat your food, sweetie. Oh, Paris. Don't come and egg her on. Eat your food, Robin. You need to put some Doc Roy's in there? I can put some Doc Roy's in there? Hey. Paris, you stop. Paris is in here trying to cause a dog fight.
What's that?
Paris is in here trying to cause a dog fight. Robin? No, she's not. Robin was snapping at her with my hand between them.
Well, you're not eating, so I'm putting it up. Sorry. Oh, I know what she wants.
I was thinking she wants the Doc Roy's, but I don't...
I found something delicious.
Bacon grease?
Yep. Bacon grease. I love some bacon flavor.
Is that something that you're certain they can have?
Yep. Just that.
Because our mama's pregnant, yeah. She's got a litter of babies in there. She's got a litter of babies in there, poor girl. She's so old. She's so old. She's so old. She's so hard. She's so hard.
Mom, switch hands.
Oh, you switch hands. Come back. She always does that with her paw. It's like she hangs on to lower herself. I think that's why she puts her paw on your wrist before she drops to the ground.
So she has,
she's like hanging on.
Yeah, she's to control her descent.
Yeah. Because she's planning to, she's just trying to drop to her back usually. That's probably rub, right? And when she's pregnant, she knows that her moms get pampered. The more you do that, the more the other dogs get excited.
Sit. No, sit. There you go. Now you're happy.
Eat your food.
Eat your food.
Don't speak yet. You spoke too soon.
You're still sweet. Hello.
Eat your food, Robin. Hi, pretty girl. Paris, come on, man. You don't need to make this more difficult. You're a good girl, Robin. Eat your food, sweetie. Did you give her the belly rub?
Yeah.
Right. After this round, she needs the belly rub on every round.
Yeah.
If you give her food again, you gotta give her the belly rub.
She needs a belly rub.
Paris. Paris, come here.
Dad's here. Dad.
And then maybe stick around for a second.
Alright, eat your food. Eat your food. Come on. Baby, come on. Eat your food.
You stay here. You stay here.
Dogs. Well, you're not eating, so. So Bradley was using which cutting board?
The one that's right there.
This one right
for
here?
For the sandwich, yeah. Was it already there or did he pull it out?
He moved it.
Aww, I'm so proud of him.
Yeah, like, yes.
I am so proud of him.
He was legit thinking about it.
All right, you may go free, Paris. I'm gonna vacuum in here.
Okay,
usually vacuum by this point. Vacuum at least once a day.
You
gonna
eat or no?
Adding the tray in here increases the rate of spread. Puppies! Hi, Remy! Did you eat a good breakfast? Did you eat a good breakfast? Huh?
No one's eating breakfast today.
Oh no, Remy.
Except for Paris, who...
Who wants everybody's breakfast.
Well, yeah, would eat anybody's breakfast. Hi, I'm Remy.
I think this thing has the target thing on.
Oh, yeah.
So it's just like zooming around. Mm. Like up, down, all around. When I'm not telling it to. Oh, wait.
Yeah, you're looking at the floor now.
Okay, yeah, I think I turned it off.
Yeah,
there we go.
They switch modes.
Yeah.
Hi, baby. Hi, baby. Hi, baby. What a good girl you are. What a good girl.
Nope, it's still doing it.
Messy. Oh, yeah, you are on the... switch mode.
And that's an impossible task with...
Ow! Myra! Oop, going up. Come on, go down. There we go. Alright. There you go.
Yay!
And don't pull the trigger.
No, it was an accident. Do it on purpose.
Why don't you turn?
See, it's still doing it!
Well, if I were you, I would turn it around so that you're aiming through the other camera.
Is it in the
ear? Okay, dog.
I hit something that I didn't mean to. I apologize, folks. I'm gonna try to keep up with it. Yeah, I can. Hey, Sue. Good morning. Oh, she's asking about Kiwi. That means Mike and Susie are on. Good morning, Mike and Susie. I sound like a 15-year-old boy. I'm like, all of a sudden. Sorry. Good morning, Mike and Susie. Hi, Remy. You're such a good girl. One of the videos I'm working on about the Our Mamas, Robin, I couldn't help but notice that throughout all of the footage, but as I edit these clips, I view them over and over, and I just started, a trend just started emerging where whenever I'm petting another dog, Robin always, she will stop what she's doing if she's not already with you, but she always comes and butts the dogs out of the way. And I noticed in particular when it was Amelia who I was trying to talk to, and she came and pushed Amelia out of the way, and then when her wagging tail hit Amelia in the head, then Amelia, poor thing, she just turned around and walked away. So it's another video I'm working on. It might just be a trailer, I don't know, I haven't decided. But that was just something I noticed about Robin. She's always gotta come and see, so she's... Oh, good girl, Paris. Good go potty, Paris. Good girl. Yep, potty,
good
potty,
girl,
train.
Paris. Good girl, Paris.
Always good to reinforce. You're such a good girl, Remy. Paula, good morning. How are you? Amelia and Mocha are still eating breakfast, if anybody is wondering where they are. Hi, Vienna. Can Rio come in?
Yeah, Rio can come in. No.
Because actually, you could macchiato or one of the boys. Because the boys are all both getting along really well.
Rio and Vienna together are quite the dynamic duo.
How big he is, you guys.
Oh, Robin there. Jeez.
Oh my gosh, he's taller than Robin.
If he gets taller than Remy, then he's big.
Stop!
Robin?
But see, Remy is like, she's all leg. It's, you got Vienna.
Yeah.
Remy's all leg. Rio is just, he's got a big,
Remy,
what are you guarding? Aw. He's like, I saw me.
See, she?
She's being feisty about something. Hi, Rio. Hi, Rio.
He was all about her when she was in heat inside of her.
So
she spilled over.
Yeah, so when Remy first went into heat, it's like as soon as she was in heat, he was all over her. That was one way that we noticed that he had a lot of interest in her. If we had let him, he would have mated with her. So that was interesting, and we were just curious, if that would even be possible, because, you know, his schlong or our folks from the UK, his todger.
Todger.
His todger.
Todger.
Was still small, and so let's see how it is now. And so, like, I don't know if, like, a tie would be successful because it has to swell in order to hold. And so if it's not matured, because I'm not just talking like, oh, it's a little bit smaller than macchiato or spike. I mean, like, it's underdeveloped. Or was. It's developed quite a bit since then.
Yeah, it's definitely developing.
Hey, Kathy, how are you? Good morning. Lisa, good morning, or afternoon to you. Robin. She's always coming for the scratches. I love her little beauty mark right there. She's all Hollywood. She's a little Miss Hollywood supermodel. Oh, Myra. See, this is the moms. They're gonna compete for affection.
It's gorgeous.
He said that right after Rio came over here. You're a good girl, Myra. How's your little puppy belly doing? We lost ya. See, now the camera's being weird again. Oh my goodness. There we go. Sorry about that. Linda, good morning. How are you? Hi, Myra. Your name's not Linda. Rio, who's a good boy? Camera's doing funny things again, sorry. When it moves up and down like that all of a sudden, I'm not doing that. That's just being weird. I don't know what it's doing. Like that. I didn't do that. There, hold, get around me. I think it's trying to focus on something. Because it has a setting where you can, like, focus on something and then it'll stay. I don't know why it would be doing that. Paris is showing off her sploot.
Her sploot?
Her sploot. Sploot. Remy, calm it down. Dang. Oh, I kind of wanted to... So, I think we've got to word it very, very carefully. I wanted to do some kind of... doggy giveaway of, I don't know if it would be, a merch item or a dog toy or something, but I just thought it would be, it would be something fun to do. But I've got to check, the wording on YouTube because, I know that you can't, you can't do, I don't know if it's, drawings you can't do or giveaways, I can't remember. But they have weird rules about it. But we could set it up so that it is over on our merch shop on Fourth Wall. We could set it all up over there. We can do giveaways over there. You guys were able to see that a little bit better. That was so funny.
What?
The moment that they heard the ice hit the floor, every single one of them turned their back at the very same moment. It was like a synchronized swimming. Yeah, because they turned their backs to the very same direction. Look at you, pretty Robin. Look how pretty her ears are. She's so beautiful. When she's pregnant, her fur, it is like, it, something about the hormones. You know, I think people do the same thing too. They're, women retain their hair more. They stop losing it. You know, just the natural hair you would have lost. And your nails tend to grow a little bit longer, faster and thicker. And I'm curious if it's the same sort of... It's because of the same sort of thing. Oh, now Rio gets to play. He's like, I want to play, cousin.
Where is
cousin?
Your...
present.
You know where
your
already seen
is? No,
not
doggies. Hey, Paris. Kelsey's description of Paris plodding around is so spot on. I love it. Even when the dogs are all excited and running, Paris is still plodding.
She reminds me of Shaggy from Scooby-Doo.
Who's barking?
Daisy.
Oh. Daisy, she's such a poor sport. I love her in pieces, but man, she can be kind of a buzzkill. Hey, Grandpa Mike! Aww. That makes me so happy. Send us a picture. Send us a picture of him, if you don't mind. We have a picture of Audrey, and she is the spitting image of Remy. It, like, blows my mind how much she looks like Remy. So I'd love to see, I would love to see Kiwi. Look at all of them watching for Drew. What is this? That's another thing. Maybe I'll put it in a caption or I'll do a voiceover, but my mating video. But something that's really interesting is during the when the females are in heat, the more fertile they get, or I should say, like, the closer they are to their fertile period, they hump other dogs of all kinds, and not for the dominant reason, but it's like
they're so horny.
Yeah, they're so horny. It's like they can't help themselves.
Like, oh, someone else is gonna hump me. I guess I can hump someone else.
Exactly. It's really bizarre. Because the boys don't do it. They just, whenever they hump the girls, they do. But the girls, they will go and they will mount other girls, they'll mount the boys, they'll mount, because it will be a genuine mount. It won't be like one of the silly ones where they're like mounting somebody's head, or it will be like a genuine, true mount.
If I had something, I would be placing it inside of you.
Right. It's just a really interesting behavior that we've noticed. Again, like, growing up, they didn't talk about dogs mating because there was just, it was like taboo to talk about dogs mating because of the spay neuter campaign. And, which I'm not, you know, complaining about or anything, it was a good campaign. But there's just so much to the whole canine mating ritual and all the things that are involved that happened, like, during the heat cycle for the mom to, like, keep in mind, and especially when they're living in a pack like we have. A lot of breeders, when they have 12 dogs that are part of the breeding program, they just are crating them. They're just organized by crates. And so we have to have we will never have enough dogs. We will never bring ourselves to have so many dogs that we need to be doing something like that. But you guys saw, like, for breakfast, that's kind of, that was one solution we have for, like, feeding, because when we started out, Missy ate in that corner, kind of by where we do coffee, by the gate. That was where Missy ate, and then Spike ate over in the corner that's kind of opposite the corner I'm in now. And then that's where the two of them ate until we got Daisy and Robin. And then Daisy and Robin, I can't remember where we moved them to, but there was a bit of a shakeup.
So we left.
Missy and Spike have always stayed there.
Missy was here, Spike was there, and then, everything else over there kind of kept changing. We had Mocha.
Yeah, so once we got Miss Daisy and Robin, they were puppies. They're like 4 weeks apart, and so we would put them in the laundry room and just have them eat together in there. And so, but once they kind of grew up, and then we had Paris and Pom Pom, we did something similar where we had, they were just separated into the laundry room. And then we would, as the puppies grew into adults, or as they would, get down the routine and doggy manners and all of that, then we would bring them out to the kitchen and they would all eat as a pack. Just like we do now, where we make sure we eat first and then, if we haven't eaten first, we at least we'll have a snack so that they can see that we have fed ourselves to our appetite. So that just reinforces our alpha status. And then like you saw Robin hesitant to eat, they will act like that if we have not eaten. All of them will be really reluctant to eat until we do. Because it's like a respect thing. It's just how it works in their world. When we had Missy, Spike, Robin, Daisy, Paris, Pom Pom, then after that, when we got Remy, that's when we started kind of separating them out, and we reduced the six in here to four and two in the laundry room, and then over time, then we converted the doggy bathroom a few months ago, and so that's been kind of like our, that's where we've had Rio and Vienna a lot, and then we put Myra in there when we first got her. Right now she's in with Remy. We kind of pair together the dogs that are close in dominance level, so that, because we feed them in order from alpha to what's the last one? Omega.
Oh yeah, Alpha and Omega.
Alpha Omega. So that's how we feed them, and it just it reinforces the hierarchy. It really helps keep law and order amongst the dogs. It reinforces that we're in charge. It really helps with things like when there's something important going on. If there's an emergency and Drew and I have to get to it, because the dogs are used to us going through doorways first and other things like that, where they have to respect that we are priority and we get first option to whatever it is that we're doing, it comes in handy when there is something truly going on. It came in handy when we first got the kittens, and I went out there, and Spike had snuck his way out with me, and I didn't know until I heard his nails on the porch of the cat shack, but when I opened the door, I opened it really slowly because I was afraid he was just gonna jump in. I was really surprised that instead of running in, he just started dancing in place. And I realized what he was doing is he was like so eager to run in that he just started dancing in place in order to kind of satisfy that need to, like, that nervous energy that he wanted to run in so badly. So he was kind of running in place, and so like things like that then really Joanette. Hi, Amelia. You're such a good girl. And he was such a good boy, too, because what's nice about things like that is I don't have to yell at him to stop or stay. Sorry about that. This is the camera doing weird things. I don't have to yell at him to stop or stay or to fight instincts. I'm not yelling commands at him that fight his instincts that are telling him otherwise. And he's actually following his instincts by doing what the dogs in the dog pack would do in that order.
No.
You don't go outside.
No. No.
You don't get to go outside.
No.
You say hi to Kiwi?
Yeah.
Say hi to Kiwi? I bet Kiwi is like barely able to hold his tail under his butt. Robin is. See, okay, so I told you guys, I mentioned earlier that I'm working on a video and I've noticed this trend in Robin where whenever I'm petting another dog, she comes over and tries to steal the show. Here she is, Exhibit A. She's like, what is this? What is this BS? I don't agree.
Exhibit R, or Robin. Robin, the horner in her.
Silly dad. Look at Paris. She's so cute. I love her. I love her pieces. I should get a video of her and send it to May. That would make her day. Sweetie. There's Paris in the sploot again. She got up and just laid back down. Pom! Who's a good girl? I love that bed, that dog bed, so much.
This one?
Yes.
Yeah. Where did that one come from?
Oh, that was an Amazon warehouse deal.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Warehouse?
Yeah, that was one we got a good deal on.
What?
It was one we got a good deal on. It was one of those beds that was like $65 and we got it for like $30 because it was returned. Mocha, what do you have? That doesn't look like a pom-pom approved item on the list. Yeah, no, it's not. All right, if Myra's not cute, then... Look how cute she is. How cute is that? Aren't they adorable? Pom-pom in the whole picture. But Myra's all, She's all snuggled up around Remy. She's not just like using her as a pillow. She's using her as like a body pillow. You guys are awesome. You're awesome, for sure. Hi, Vienna. Yeah, you're a good girl. Hi, Paris. Many people ask us if, Paris and Vienna and Rio recognize that she is their mom and, you know, understand that relationship. And so it's kind of like an ongoing sort of observation that we have. And so I would say lately, I think that they have basically no idea that there ever was a mother-puppy relationship between them. However, they do have a very strong bond that is very obvious is much more intense. Like, they still have, I think they have that, Paris still has that sort of maternal sort of bond and love for them, but she doesn't place it as, they don't have a concept of mom, you know, they don't understand that sort of thing. And so I think that her bond for them has remained, and same for them, like when they see her, they feel comfort, you know, just like when a child sees their mom, you know, when they come home from school after a day playing with the kids in the class, they see their mom and, you know, pull up to pick them up. And it's just the sight of their mother brings them a sense of comfort. And so I think it's a lot like that. Where with Paris, they just have those feelings of security. Because I don't think you can really undo that, especially if when they're remaining in the very same environment and we're not doing anything to pull them away from it. We're not, like, actively separating them or discouraging them from having any sort of relationship. And so it's really kind of, like, developing probably naturally, I would say. And so it's been interesting to watch develop. And it'll be really interesting to see how it is when they're, like, full adults, when they're not just, what are they, 9 months old now? Almost 9 months?
Yeah.
When they're like 18 months old, it'll be really interesting to see how they are.
January 1st.
Yeah, because maybe when they're adults and they no longer have the puppy exception around the pack, which I will say their little puppy exception that they have is wearing thin. The adults are giving them less and less leeway. I'd say they're probably like. They're kind of treated how, like, you would treat a 17-year-old who's preparing to enter the world. Like, do you not agree, or are you laughing at me?
No, I'm just, I love your analogy, or your comparison.
Well, you know, when they're 17, you start letting them make their own decisions, and you hope that they're good ones. But when you screw up, usually it's going to be a lot harsher because you have higher expectations and... Oops.
What?
The phone. Sorry about that. But you have higher expectations and, you know, you don't want your kids to make a mistake that ruins their lives. But so with dogs, it's like they have pretty much taught them all that they can, and so Rio and Vienna, this one, if you're less familiar with this, Vienna is this one. So they're almost 9 months old now. They were born New Year's Day, New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. Rio New Year's Eve and Vienna New Year's, no, the other way around. Vienna New Year's Eve and Rio New Year's Day. But the other dogs are kind of done teaching them, and so now when they are overstepping their space or...
They're getting corrected.
Yeah, they're getting corrected, and they're getting corrected more like they would remind an adult. Yeah, they're like giving them a preview of what they've got to face. You know, kind of like when you tell your kids, like, you know, when you're an adult, this is something that you would be arrested for. I lost my train of thought. I was just saying that they're done.
Yeah.
I think they've pretty much learned all there is to learn, Rio and Vienna. And they're kind of just treating them as they would adults, with the only exception being that they won't erupt into a dog fight if Rio and Vienna are super, like, resistant. They won't let it get to the point of a dog fight. They still do play with kid gloves. They still treat them with kid gloves when it comes to discipline.
Especially with preference for them also, I was going to say.
They're so cute.
You want a pop tart?
I do. Those are so good.
Just hold one.
This is a potty tray. Really needs to be changed, so if you use potty trays, if it gets to this point, it needs to be changed. But this is the little cubby that they like to go into. It's like just enough room to wrestle and play without the grown-ups bothering you. Girls! And then mom is over here like, guys, keep it down. Myra keeps doing this. This is the third time I've caught them like this, and in completely separate occasions with Myra wrapped around Remy. Let's see if Myra fixes this. I wanted to get by. Even Pom Pom's over here like, you know you're on video, right? They're videotaping you. Silly. I'm so
real,
like I tried to warn her. Silly Mocha.
What?
I said silly Mocha. So we're gonna plan for the For Missy's live stream, the Missy Puppies, we're going to start that, like, at lunchtime, because what I'm going to go and work on right now is my video about the video I was working on this morning. Not the one for the channel members, but for just the regular channel. It was just kind of about the moms and the puppies were playing in it, but it was... It's the one I described about how Robin was buttoned into every take whenever I was filming and petting and approaching another dog. Within like 2 seconds, Robin appeared. Yes, you did. She's like, I don't want to lose a moment of that attention.
I'm gonna grab that other little bed.
best not draw. Purchase. For those of you who watch our other live stream with the little puppies, you probably recognize this bed that I brought home yesterday. Bay and I went out shopping. It smells like the babies, so the dogs are going nuts. I went to a store called Five Below. If you are in our area, you're probably familiar with it. I don't know if they're national or not, but everything in the store is $5 and below. And so I checked out their pet section, because who can't? And these were their little beds that they had. They just called them crate pads, and they were $4. And I didn't really look at it until I got home, but when I got home, I realized that it's kind of like a knockoff of that big black one we have, where the middle of it has more of a pillowy, it has a lot of stuffing in the middle, so that there's the pockets around that the puppies can get comfortable in. And so the puppies love it. They're all sleeping in it right now. They're all tucked away in their little spots. But we usually have, for our little puppies, we usually have some sort of nest for them to kind of help keep them together, because it's difficult when they have a heating pad. It's difficult for them to figure out where everybody is when it's just warm everywhere. So, I was going to bring this in here and just put it over by the island for puppies to play in, but I imagine they're all going to go nuts with it because it smells like the babies.
See robins and macchiatos.
Oh my god, me too. And yeah. Fingers crossed that Remy's got Missy. Remy's, it's not a Remy issue, that it was all just a fluke, and we can see some tricolors and
Light color.
But Drew and I we're gonna have our coffee, and so I'm gonna work on that video. Also be working on the video for our channel members. I'm almost done with that one, so I'm hoping to have that up for you guys soon. Because it's tilted, you can't satisfy your type A need to have the stool lined up with the cabinets. Good. It's gotta be kind of
well. Off.
These are such good doggies. Sorry about that.
The fun word. Yeah, the only thing I don't like about this one is that you can't see it if it is doing the reconnect fizz.
I know.
Here, I'm just walking by. And
well, we'll pull up the studio and I'll let you know. You'll see it on that.
The back bedroom door that goes to the four sisters. And I saw somebody said that the puppies needed water. They have water around the corner by the door that goes to the back door, and they have water just inside the laundry room here. So it's just out of sight.
Puppies.
I love when Mama plays with her babies. It's so sweet. I'm so excited to watch Pom Pom and Mocha together, like Paris and Vienna. Right, Deanna? Right, Deanna? That's who's barking so loud. Yeah. You need to eat more.
Thank you. All right. Thank you. Myra.
God. Hey! Missy! What are you doing out?
know what happened there. Drew and I are such foodies that we have dessert during the day, too. So, we're having dessert while the kids are at school, because then we won't get bothered about getting dessert around to everybody. And the kids can have theirs later.